The samples you've recovered. I still don't have enough. I need you to go inside a hive. The substance at the center, the material the virus is producing, I think it's the key. With it, I think I can reverse the effect of the virus. And Alex, for what it's worth, I'm sorry it had to play out like this.
Don't be sorry. Just cure this thing.
Mercer, you're a hard man to find. I've been looking forward to this.
Who are you?
Who sent you? You should pick your friends more carefully, Mercer.
You being here means Karen Parker sold me out.
Watch out for that! Mercer. This, and then a hole in the ground. Figure out what you want this side of the hole. damage! Pour it on! Is that all you got? Night.
You think you've won, Mercer? You don't even know what fucking game you're playing.
Well, I can tell you all you need to know about Penn Station.
In a way, I feel sorry for you.
Zeus is down. Bring in the containment device.
What the hell did he do to me?
Damage!
Pour it on!
man, you look like shit, but this might help.
McMahon?
No, but they're watching someone for him. Okay, it's this doctor named Bradley Ragland.
Where is he?
Whoa, whoa, whoa. He's a good guy. Okay, you find him, he helps us get to McMullen. He's uptown at St. Paul's Hospital. He runs some work there. Wait, wait, hold up. There's more. All right, so I did some research on Hope, Idaho. It was an army town. On July 21st, 1969, it vanishes from the map. The official word was that it was an anti-government gun nut standoff. Some militia killed a bunch of people, and the feds killed the militia. Now, there's only one survivor. Notice a girl, second from the left?
Elizabeth Green.
Who looks an awful lot like a college student these days. Not bad for 55 years old.
Hope Idaho was an experiment.
How could you possibly know that?
The people I've killed, they're in me. I can hear them, see the things they've done.
What the fuck are you talking about?
I can understand it all. I'm supposed to do these things, but it's right. I can feel it.
Find Ragland and ask him about McMullen.
Feeding on me.